Welcome back to the basic tutorial. In this part, we'll learn about using the updated mirror interface, creating 3D guides from drawn curves with the Loft feature, and saving or animating cameras with sequence. I recommend watching part 1 and 2 before this tutorial if you haven't yet. Also, don't forget to download the assets before drawing by the link in the description. Okay, let's start by drawing the iconic orange headphones. These headphones may be quite challenging to draw, as it's not a simple box shape. A reference to trace on may help a lot. In the last part, we learned how to use image references in the clipboard. This time, we'll import the reference directly into the 3D space. Double tap with 3 fingers to switch to the orthographic view, and double tap to the perfect front side. Open the stage panel and tap the small geometric shape icon in the middle. This is the resource tab. Let's import the first image we've downloaded. Tap the import text, then select the photo library. Choose the image with the front of the headphone and import it. You should now see the image in the space. The other groups might be in the way, so let's turn them off. Now let's add the second image. Double tap to switch to the side view, then return to the resource tab and repeat the process. This time, select the image with the side view. Let's set their position. Just like selecting groups, press and hold on to the images in the tab to select and move them. Select both images and use the joystick to move them upward. You can also adjust the opacity of the images by moving the slider on the left. Let's set the opacity to about 30%. Now, if you look at the right side of the resource tab, you can see a cube with a black top. When the cube is black, you can draw directly on it as a 3D guide. Now tap the cube once. This state means that you can see it, but you can't draw on it anymore. Tap it once more to hide the resource, like hiding a group. Now let's keep the image of the front side in a black cube and start drawing. Go back to the group tab, add a new group, and change the name to Headphone Sketch. Choose the square brush and change its size to 15. Set the color to a slightly dark blue and the opacity to 100%. As you can see, the headphones are symmetrical, so we'll draw only one side of it, but with turning on the mirror. Tap the mirror icon here, next to the clipboard. When you tap it, 3 icons, each representing the X, Y, and Z axis, will appear below. Let's turn on the green one now. Draw along the reference, checking out the opposite side being reflected in real time. Turn on the stable stroke if you want a more clean drawing. Hide the headphone front image if you're done, and turn on the side one. We're going to edit the curve slightly. From the front view, select the left part of the curve, and you'll see the other side is also selected in a blue color. Double tap to switch to the side view. Duplicate it and move it slightly to match the thickness of the headphones. You can make further adjustments in the side view as needed. Let's turn the front image back on, and this time, have both images visible, but we're not going to use them as 3D guides for now. Alright, begin with the front view. We'll create a guide for the sponge part of the headphones. Next, switch to the side view, double tap, and draw a circle or line to the image. Now let's add a speaker part next. Sketch a guide in the front view, then move to the side view and trace the lines from the image. And delete some curves if you want. By referencing one side for the 3D guide and the other for the curves, you can quickly make a blueprint into a 3D sketch. Select the headphone jack part and move it slightly. Now, let's move on to the next step. Go to the Group tab, add a new group, and name it to Headphone Paint. Turn off close images and go to the top view. Draw a guide in the middle of the sketch. Switch to the front view and change the brush size to 55. Fill in the headband section by drawing along the guide. Select the curves we just drew. Once selected, duplicate the curves from the bottom menu. Move the duplicated curves to fill in the inside of the sketch. Repeat the process a few times until it's filled. If you're done, it's time to move on to the silver frame. Change the brush to the last one on the list, the same one we used for the player's buttons in part 1. Change the color to a cool gray and start drawing. Turn on or off stable stroke depending on your preference. We also need to paint the speaker part. Double tap to go to the front, draw this guide, switch to the side view. Change the brush to the third one and adjust the size to 80. For the headphone jack, change the color to a slightly darker gray. Great! I hope you remember that 3D guides can be selected too. Press and hold with the pen, and use the 3D joystick to move it slightly along the y-axis. Back to draw mode. Select a bright milky gold color, and paint the circle. Move on to the sponge. It has this vibrant orange color. To paint this area, let's change the brush to the second one, and increase the size to 240. Choose the color like this, and draw a guide in the front view. Switch to the side view and follow the outline we've drawn. Fill in the inside, and there you go. Let's take a look in the perspective view. Looks pretty good already. One of the great things of Feather is that you can change the color or brush type even after drawing. Open the group tab and select the headphone sketch group. Maybe a lighter blue would look better. This time, select the headphone paint group and duplicate it. Change the color to black and move it slightly downward for a quick shadow effect. Lower the opacity to make it more realistic. You can erase or refine the colors in more detail like this. In the group tab, there's an arrow icon next to the eyes. You can shift the selected strokes to the group you want by pressing this button. Select the shadow from Headphone Paint 1 and move it into the original Headphone Paint group. Then, delete the empty group. Lastly, turn off the mirror icon. Let's relocate the headphones we drew. Turn on all of the groups and select the groups related to the headphones. Use the 3D joystick to place them where you want. Next, we'll draw the headphone cable. Let's try to create a natural looking cable as possible. Switch to the orthographic view first. Open the group tab and add a new group named cable. Use the square brush again. Set the thickness to 50. And the color to a dark blue. We'll start from the front view. Imagine a wire lying on the ground as you draw the guide. Go back to the top view and draw the wire. Keep the stable stroke on, as these kind of wires have very clean lines and don't tangle that much. Try to draw it in several parts, since it's hard to draw it in one go. Repeat this process a few times to complete the cable. Switch between the top and other side views while drawing the guides. Also, refer to similar wires if you have one around for a more realistic and dynamic line. To draw the part where the cable plugs in, first draw the guide in the top view. Switch to the perspective view to draw the actual cable. Open the group tab and duplicate the cable group if you're satisfied with the cable's shape. Select the duplicated group and change its color as you like. Use the 3D joystick to move it slightly upward, and change the brush size to 43. Change the color of each part to a rainbow if you want. It'll make the drawing look vibrant. Let's organize the groups in the same way. Selecting already drawn curves and changing their brush types or colors is one of the most common actions in Feather. Let's explore more by adding a background object. Open the group tab and add a new group. Rename it to Environment. Switch to orthographic view and tap the draw icon once more to change the mode. Move to the front view and draw a 3D guide that lays flat on the floor. Switch to the top view and double tap. We'll try advanced features this time. Draw any winding curve and hold it for a while. You can control the tension of the curve by sliding like this. One more thing, by holding down from a single point and slide, you can create the perfect circle. Let's use this feature to draw a CD on the floor. In the top view, draw a circle like this. Close the 3D guide and select the circle. Change the brush right here, which is the widest one. Let's try a light sky blue this time. Select it again and duplicate it. Lock the 2D joystick. Make sure the joystick icon changes to a square. Drag the top left button on the joystick to scale it up or down precisely. Make it slightly larger, then change the brush type to the square one. Let it fit the outer edge of the CD, and change the color to a darker shade. With the Loft feature, you can create 3D guides with the curves you drew. To use Loft, we need to create the key curves first. Select the outer edge curves of the CD. Duplicated it and use the joystick to move it upward, then shrink it a little. Duplicated it once more, and make it bigger and wider this time. Unlock the joystick and stretch it horizontally. Now, we're ready to use Loft. Tap the draw icon and tap Loft from the bottom menu. Select the circles from the bottom, just like using the select tool. You can also control the tension of the guide with the slider on the left side. Tap Done if you want to start drawing on it. Feel free to decorate the surroundings as you like. This is just a peek of this feature's usage, so look forward to more deep tutorials. Let's do one more last thing. There's nothing like shadows to add depth to any artwork. Well, we don't have rendering or shading options yet, so we're going to draw the shadows manually. But don't worry, it's so simple in Feather. Start by drawing a guide on the ground just below the CD. Add a new room named Shadow. Move the camera around and imagine you are a light bulb or the sun. Find the angle where the objects look brightest, which is where the light projects shadows. Next, using the flat brush, outline the edges of the objects. Go to the other sides, outline the remaining edges, and fill in. And that's all. This is how to draw shadows in Feather, and also the exact fundament of shading. Turn off the global axis and grid in the environment tab and take a look around your drawing. Perfect! If you press and hold with one finger to any stroke or grid, you can pin an orbit point, which makes the camera rotate around it. Press and hold any blank space to erase it. In the View tab inside the System menu, you can open the sequence. Save camera shots by pressing the button on the right. Add some shots yourself. You can play animations with the saved shots from the Play tab. Also, you can control your camera by dragging the timeline like this. Well, this is the end of the basic tutorial. We'll be back with more videos soon. If you have any questions, leave a comment, and don't forget to subscribe and like for more updates. Thanks for watching.